Key West, a peaceful strip of islands located south of Florida. It is a place of opulent charm, feral chickens, and daily visits by the cruise ship elite. But the calm is breaking in this town, and what was once sacred has been sullied by a new infestation, scooter gangs. This fascinating look at the culture behind these neo-gypsy ruffians begins in the late morning, as the sins of the previous evening make it difficult for them to arise. Our cameraman takes advantage of their stupor to get as close as possible. This behavior has never before been caught on tape. As you can see, members of this four-person troop are constantly fighting for position. This is the one our crew came to call Little Eric. Clearly the most passive of the group, he is always quiet, and left to do chores while the others discuss the previous evening's activities.
Ow, what was that?
It was a big gross hair.
Ow.
Hey Dave, look at me. I love you. Thank you. Dude, this floor I was talking about yesterday, like, took a turn for the best.
What?
I said it took a turn for the best.
Was it?
Why are you videotaping me?
This is the result of what Big Eric was talking about with the one we called Dave, or Bear. The scooter gang accosted an elderly librarian, stole her bike, and gleefully tossed it into this lagoon. The scooter gang begins each day with some time by the pool, suntanning. After a while, they will enter the pool and perform rambunctious acts, usually with fatal consequences to innocent bystanders. After they have freshened up, the gang hops on their hogs and heads to town. Big Eric and the one we affectionately know as Pasty generally take the lead, as they are the most confident on their rides. In fact, Little Eric is rarely seen, as his skittish nature tends to relegate him to stopping at red lights and stop signs, causing him to often be separated from the group. Pasty is more vocal than Big Eric, and often chastises passers-by with a threatening display of gestures, after which he will speed off.
Patrick.
Yes.
The ones that are up there.
Yes.
The chickens are never safe. As the sun goes down, the local water people lock their doors. An eerie calm settles over the water. At this deceptively pleasant time of day is when the scooter gang becomes restless. Big Eric is becoming concerned over Pasty's increasing confidence, and he has to assert his authority. He begins with quasi-homosexual hugging. Pasty remains passive. Big Eric then proceeds to mount Pasty, who offers little resistance. All the while, Bear hovers in the background, biding his time to see who wins the contest. As if to answer this unasked question, Big Eric stands upright on Pasty, his body language indicating he is still leader of the group. Assured of his dominance, Big Eric sits upon Pasty's face in a final assertion of his status. Pasty displays a smile in deference to Big Eric, but his true feelings are soon clear. He scowls as Bear makes a futile attempt to raise his stature, an attempt that is soon thwarted.
Oh, I got the DDT.
Drop it.
Not on the tent.
You're out.
This quaint estate is the headquarters for the citizen-run Coalition Against Scooter Mania. And though they have employed military vessels, fighter aircraft, and undercover officers, they have had little success apprehending the gangs. Perhaps with a greater understanding of these creatures, a solution can be found. Only time will tell what happens to the wild scooter gangs, Key West, Florida.
Mudslides. They got sushi in the mall. Water bottles.